Buenos dias. I'm Ramon Martinez from La Raza Historical Society of Santa Clara Valley. And today is Saturday, December 9. And I'm downtown in San Jose visiting a lowrider book release. Okay, the most important part of the event is Don Victor Garza from La Raza Roundtable. And he's buying something to eat. Lo que vale más aquí es la comida. Miren qué bonita.
Trabajando muy duro.
¿Y usted cómo se llama?
Yo me llamo Asunción Cruz. Vengo del estado de Oaxaca, México.
Ah, Oaxaca.
Oaxaca presente aquí dándole duro al trabajo.
¿Cuánto tiempo ha estado aquí?
Voy a cumplir 3 años.
¿Tres?
En agosto.
Muy bien, qué bonito es Oaxaca. ¿De cuál parte?
Valles Centrales, donde se hace el barro verde en Santa María de Chocla.
Ah,
ahí cuando
sí, porque ya...
¿Conoce usted Oaxaca?
Un poco, ha visitado la ciudad de Oaxaca y unos alrededores, a la comunidad que donde hacen alebrijes.
Oh, sí. Cuando guste ir al Tule, es muy bonito. Nuestro estado se caracteriza por muchas culturas, gastronomía, Monte Albán, Mitla. Nuestras playas son hermosas, Huatulco,
y también yo he ido a donde hacen alfombra.
Ah, de hermano.
Puede ser, sí.
Tapete.
Yo creo, sí. ¿Sí? Pictures of kids at this event.
Wave to the camera, say hi to the camera, look.
Yeah.
Wave. What's your name?
Delilah.
I used to be on YouTube.
Yeah, you used to be on YouTube. Are these your kids?
Yes.
Why did you bring them today?
For Santa, and to look at the cars.
And your name is?
Umar.
Why are you here today?
To enjoy the holiday spirit with the kids, enjoy the car scene, let them meet Santa.
Thank you.
Yes, sir.
Here.
This is a beautiful car.
Joy, and we're happy to be here. How you doing? Emily, say hey.
Why did you bring the kids today?
Well, because it's a bit of my family, lowriding and being a part of where I'm from, the east side of San Jose, all my life. So I want my kids to know where we're from, being Chicano, being proud of who we are. Para.
How about you? Why did you bring the kids?
We have a lowrider ourselves, so we find it important to make sure our kids are exposed to a lot of authentic culture and proud to be Latino heritage, so we bring them out as much as we can for the community.
Eva.
Andy.
Daniel.
Daniel. Oigo un acento en su... En sus voces. Háblenme a la comunidad en español. ¿Qué pasa? ¿Qué está pasando aquí?
Estamos trabajando. Aquí venimos a ver el evento. A limpiar aquí, a trabajar en el evento. Está muy bonito y pues que sean más eventos para que nos acompañen.
Find us on Instagram, dtsp.sj. You can find us downtownscreenprinters.com. Personals, A-L-I-K-S, alex.mahn, Alex Mon. And we're around at local events. Come see us.
Hi, my name is Lorena. I'm helping with the screen printing.
Señor Daryl Cortez, I also want you to add, tell me about your career in San Jose Police Department and your work besides Shop with a Cop and producing the son who wrote this beautiful book.
Well, thank you very much.
No, tell me about
Thank
your
you.
Police.
Thank you very much, Dr. Ramon. My son, Ricardo, has published the book. As we mentioned earlier, myself, I was a 30-year career veteran of the San Jose Police Department, working in a myriad of assignments throughout my career. And I worked in a lot of community outreach programs and San Jose's crime prevention unit. So it's always been a desire of mine to bridge, to bring the community together with law enforcement so we can rebuild that trust so that families and children see a different perspective of policing. And it's all about community engagement and supporting one another. It takes a village. And police officers are more than the badges they wear. And so we just want to thank everybody for coming out today. And happy holidays.
Daryl, did you ever own a lowrider or a really cool car?
You know, one of my first cars was a 74 Buick Regal half Landau top, a two-door. I wish I still had that car in my possession today, but I ended up selling it. And that was my only claim to fame, where I probably would have really loved to fix it up and bring it out here today, but I didn't have that opportunity.
Tell me how much you sold it for and what it would be selling for today.
Oh, well, that first car came from the Buick dealership on Kylie Boulevard, Saratoga. And what I sold it for, because it didn't need a lot of work, so probably about several hundred dollars to another mechanic. Today, had I fixed it up and kept it, probably several thousand dollars in today's market.
And I'm also happy to announce that as of next week, the book is actually going to be available at the San Jose Public Library. So they bought some books, and you can check them out for free. Yeah, we want to make sure we have access to this education, to this knowledge here. And I especially want to shout out New Style Car Club for organizing all the cars out here. To all the trucks that are displayed over here, they're gonna help us transport these toys to Los Amigos de Guadalupe and Sacred Heart Community School, or Nativity School, that are at the hearts of the Lowrider movement from East San Jose to West San Jose. So thank you, we have a few more hours out here. Definitely get your autographs, you don't wanna miss out before they leave, but I truly appreciate it from the bottom of my heart for everybody showing up and having a really great positive event out here. Thank you.
Mario Madrid, I can recognize you anywhere.
That's yellow.
Hi, what's your name?
Ricardo. Ricardo. Go by Mr. 1777. Hi, Mario.
Hi. And Mario Madrid is the son of Sonny Madrid, who everyone knows started Lowrider Magazine. So talk to us, Sonny. How you doing?
Good, good. Just here, they asked to come and represent my dad, so here I am. Spreading the word, you know, and adding a little bit of San Jose history, you know, from the Chicano movement to the lowriding. So, sharing the word.
Good. I was going to ask you, did you ever own a lowrider car?
No, I personally didn't.
In the family?
Yeah, in the family. My dad had it.
What did he have?
He had a 62, he had a sedan delivery, and then other cars that he had. But I remember the sedan delivery was the fun car. It was like a hearse.
Where was the, when Sonny started publishing Lowrider, where did he publish the first one?
Where, what city?
Oh. Where? Yeah.
San Jose.
Okay, where?
It was printed in Maya Graphics, Maya Printing, Willow.
By, what was the name of the company?
Maya Press. Maya Press.
Maya Press. Are they still around?
Last time I saw him was maybe, I want to say in the early 2000s. He had a little shop off of San Carlos.
What's the person's name?
Armando. Armando.
Last name?
That I don't know.
Okay. Maya Press, he did the first publish. Do you know how many copies they printed?
Supposedly 1,000 and then another 500 or something like that I've seen.
Okay.
Right now. I don't know exactly, but something like that.
Okay, this is a copy from the first Lowrider magazine.
Yes.
And Mario, who's the woman in the picture?
Gloria. Gloria, she's from Soledad. But how about this one? Remember that?
Okay. Mario's showing me a magazine cover called Trucha. Tell me about it, Mario.
Trucha was the magazine that he was involved with, or actually he was doing before Lowrider. So this is in the early 70s, and it was back when he was more political about his publications.
Is that also from San Jose?
Yes, San Jose. This is when he was at San Jose State.
Do you know of any of the other people who did this with him?
I believe Antonio Corrales was part of the layout and some of the armor. Other than that, a lot of different people, you know how it was with the collectives, with Bronce, Machete, and La Palabra. He was working out before that. A lot of different people.
I think that I confuse the first place he printed Lowrider, which you just cleared up. I always say it was at the Maxa house behind Maria's on 13th Street. What was he doing there? I remember
that was Machete.
I remember going there. Tell me about him there.
So Maxa was kind of like, as far as from what I understand, the hub of a lot of Chicano activity back in those days. He had the Black Berets at Guariba, and also the printing shop was there. I think it was Carlos or somebody, I forget the name. But over there is where they printed Machete, Bronce, and La Palabra. And then after that, they stopped working over there, and then they did Trucha. But this one I don't believe was printed there. I think Armando started to do this one. This is where he met him, the Maya Press guy. And then there was another one after this, the San Jose Community News. That was another one that came after that, and then Lowrider.
Okay. Mario, what are you showing me here?
I'm showing you the San Jose community news. So this was done after this and before Lowrider. So, you know, my dad had a long history of publications within the movement, as well as being an activist, you know. And pretty much by the time Lowrider came out, he knew how to do everything, you know.
I served in Vietnam from 68 to 70, and I also have a group called Veterans Helping Veterans. We're out of Milpitas. We meet at the Omega on Calaveras, Park Victoria, the Ocean Market Plaza. So we're there from 10 to 12. Twice a month. It's the first and second Tuesday of each month.
Yeah. Princess.
Oh, okay.
Honor my cousin who's doing this, and also to reminisce of the old days when I used to go to La Raza Park over off of Hillier Park.
And what kind of a car did you ever ride around in those days?
I had a 77 Mark V, Lincoln Mark V.
You had it?
Yep.
All right.
I had one, and then I had a 78 Camaro.
Didn't you need a man to fix it up?
No, that was my car. I had no man at all, and I was happy, and I fixed it up myself. Everybody thought I had a no man, but I didn't. It was mine. Nothing like that. I do remember the 50s and driving to Maine on Saturday night, seeing all these hot cars out there.
On what street?
First Street. It was two ways at that time. It wasn't just one way like it is now. So we'd see our friends in their cars. We just go round and round from first to second and all the way around and start all over again. It was a lot of fun. Had a good time. Okay, I'm Yvonne Andrade, and in the early 70s, I had a 72 Camaro, and I had a 61-62 Impala, and I used to belong to street escorts, and every Saturday, like clockwork, we'd be cruising up and down Story and King and be at the Jack in the Box.
My name is Cindy O'Neill. Ricardo Cortez is my cousin, so we're here to support him, and we're having a good time.
And did you ever go lowriding?
When I was in San Jose, yes. First and second. Was it first and second? First was one way, second, yes.
Who did you ride with?
You know what? I wasn't even supposed to be in a car. I was little.
How old were you?
Grade school. Probably with her.
Are you?
She was gonna babysit me.
How old were you at that time?
Oh, I was 16, 17 years old. Dragging
the baby. She had to babysit me, so.
Ah.
She went everywhere.
This is an old historic story.
Yep.
This is an old historic story. People think that Mexicans didn't take care of their kids. And you better believe that they did not allow their kids to go anywhere. And so they found a way.
Well, my folks bought, they bought me a car. Who wasn't bought me the car, so I'm ready to go.
So
my name is Elizabeth, by the way. Quinn Coleman.
And so you took this little kid with you.
Yep. I even threw up in one.
Yes, she did.
I ate too many cherries.
Oh, Okay, I'm finally here, guys.
My name is Jay O'Neill. I am every kind of family. Ricardo Cortez, Daryl.
Why are you here?
Because the family, because my wife.
Support the family.
Support the family.
Did you ever have a car or a ride around your Lowrider?
I had so many good cars.
Tell me.
I had my first car, 37 Ford Deluxe Coupe. I had numerous 51 Chevy, two-door hardtop. I used to cruise the strip in San Leandro with a 51 Merc with a 58 old J2 motor in it. Slicks. Yeah, I should be shot for all the good cars I've had. 55 Chevys, numerous 51 Fords. I had a 44 Deluxe Coupe. I had a 28 Model A pickup with a small back window. Too many to.
If you had all those cars today, all at once, how rich would you be?
I'd be a millionaire. My 44 was a deluxe coupe, had a loaded flathead in it, with a Frenzel supercharger, old school. It, when I stopped at a stop sign, the whole body would rock.
My name is John Coleman, and I'm here because of Ricardo. He's my wife's cousin. I never did any low riding. I'm just here to support the family.
Where did you grow up?
El Sobrante, up by Redmond Knoll, Richmond, that area.
And were there low riders when you were young up there?
Nope, not that I remember.
My name is Elizabeth. I just want to say we were the first Hispanic family on our street on Ridge Vista. Our neighbor did not want us there. We were the first Hispanics to move into that street. So she talked to the realtor and asked them to find us another house. My father was very, very angry. And he said, if they want to find us another house, they can buy it and pay for us. We are not moving. So we stayed there for the rest of my mom and dad's life on Ridge Vista in San Jose on the east side.
In what year was this, more or less?
Probably in the 50s. Late 40s, early 50s. My father was born in Sonora, Mexico. He came over with his family. He was 2 years old. He had 12 brothers and sisters. So being the first Hispanic family on that street, I couldn't understand why people didn't like us. I didn't know what we had done wrong. They didn't want us there. But we stayed. We had many, many friends. And it was a wonderful area once that family left. Once they were gone, all the other neighbors welcomed us, and we were happy.
Ricardo Cortez, I came here to film you because you're an author of a book, and that's so important. But I want you to know that what's even more important is I just found out that you're the son of Daryl Cortez. Now you're the real deal.
Yeah, yeah.
Daryl and I have been friends for many, many years.
And so, we have.
And I know the history of your grandfather,
right.
Second World War.
Yep.
And what we're going to need to do is I want to sit with you sometime and talk to you, because I never captured his grandfather's story when he was alive.
Oh, okay.
And we kept saying, let's go see him. And it didn't happen. So don't worry, we're going to come back, collect pictures. And we're going to make sure that they go into the history of the city.
We'll make it happen.
And the county.
Yeah,
that'd be
great.
So I'm ready to go.
Let me get
Santa, okay. Would you say hello to the kids out there?
Hi, Merry Christmas, everybody. Santa's getting a Coke here. Oh, my goodness. So refreshing.
Sanya, did you come in your sleigh or did you come in a lowrider car?
They brought me in this lowrider right here. I was brought in this beautiful lowrider right here.
Good. I'm sure they didn't trust you to have Rudolph inside.
Rudolph's back home getting fattened up for the big day, Christmas Eve.